With color grading, subtlety is key. But knowing what is subtle and when it's gone too far can be the line that you blow by super fast. So, are you avoiding these very common color grading mistakes? I'm Rafael, and welcome to the channel where our goal is to always fix it in camera and then finesse it in post. And one of the first things to be aware of with color grading is if you're pushing the contrast and saturation too hard. Because small movements can make big impacts, but big movements will turn off your viewers. Early on, almost everyone pushes the grade too far, because that's when you really start seeing the difference from your original starting point. But remembering that subtlety is key, the goal should be to have a clean and natural feel. And I don't mean that it should look real, but that it should feel as though it belongs in that world. It's about avoiding the clown face painting vibe. Another common mistake is not using the scopes and only trusting your eyes or the monitor. It's the fastest way to make sure that your colors are not accurate. Using scopes allows you to trust the numbers and not be fooled by your eyes or the monitor or the environment that you're color grading in. Just think back to any optical illusion that you have seen and how it can trick the brain into seeing something that isn't actually there. Understanding how to use and read scopes, you'd be able to color grade on the shittiest black and white monitor. Not saying that you should, but the scopes don't lie. Also, don't forget to turn off night mode on your computer. The next mistake is not checking skin tones. People never notice when skin tones are correct, but they instantly notice when they are wrong. Weird skin tones will ruin 100% of your shots. And that's because humans are great at seeing someone that looks off or sick. So unless your character is meant to look weird, check your skin tones by using the vector scope. And I have a whole video that goes over how to check your skin tones. The link is in the description. Another mistake is not understanding the intended viewer of the video and mixing odd color combos without thinking about the color contrast for the scene. Color theory is a really good subject to read up on, but understanding the basics of how colors affect human psychology is key to communicating the feeling that you are trying to achieve. It plays on a much deeper level than the surface value. And different regions of the world and cultures respond very differently to certain color combos. So make sure you get your color theory game on. The next common mistake is thinking that color grading is a requirement for every single scene. There are many cases where a basic color conform or color correction will be more than enough. And depending on the project that you're working on, it may not require any color grading at all. This next common mistake is one that I've caught myself doing over and over again, and it's not taking breaks. Once you've done a color pass, you really do need to step away from your monitor. Let your eyes rest, preferably on something that is neutral. And when you come back, the grade that you thought was perfect may look absolutely awful. So it is key to give your eyes some rest from what you're working on. And here is a bonus common mistake that I find a lot of people do, relying on LUTs too heavily. LUTs can be great, but they give creative control over to others. Someone else has made the color choices for your project. So it's important to understand how to color correct and grade a shot from scratch without LUTs or plugins. And that's exactly what this video goes over if you want to grade your own footage. So make sure you check it out. And remember to give this video a thumbs up if you liked it. Also, I live stream on my second channel where I deep dive on the creative process as well as freelance financials. So make sure you check it out. As always, thanks for watching.